everybody, this is Praxis, and my dad is upstairs helping me with electrical work today, and while I'm sure a lot of you guys will be very interested in seeing that, you're stuck down here with me in the basement utility room doing more foam work. If you guys didn't see the video yesterday, essentially what I'm doing is I'm putting foam to protect this pantry area from the heat of the living space. That's my practical reason for doing this. There is going to be warmth out there. I'm going to be storing food in here. It's good to keep this cool. I left some of the floor uninsulated here to try to keep this area a little bit cooler. Nice natural 50 degree thermal mass down here. It makes food last a little bit longer. The other reason that I'm doing this is that I'm kind of forced by code that I have to insulate this wall because of my having left some of this area uninsulated. They say that I need 4 inches of foam on these walls in order to, satisfy the code because, the idea is that this area is an unheated space, so they're treating it as though it's going to be 10 degrees below zero at night in the middle of winter. Never going to happen. 50-degree thermal mass. 50 degrees is as cool as it's ever going to get in here. Maybe if I left all the windows out there open and open this door, maybe I could get this place down to like 45. This is from experience of, living in the last house built kind of similarly. But anyway, I had to insulate this wall for those reasons. I'm kind of skimping out. I'm not doing the full 4 inches. I'm putting some, and then I'm going to put a nice clean layer of 1 inch over the whole thing, and who's ever going to go into the wall and check? But I do want some foam here because it's going to protect the pantry from the warmth over there. And I'm using all these pieces of crazy scrap foam that any other normal person would have thrown out. I kept all of them, and they're really useful for going in here. What I've been doing is just putting them up piece at a time. There's a little gap right here. This piece looks about the right size to fit in there. I'm going to snap this one off at right about that length right there. That piece is going to come back into action later on. Put a little bit of foam in here. I think I'm going to put this in first. Sometimes I'll put them in first. And I'm putting the foil side, when they're missing foil, I'm putting the foil side facing the heat side, because you're not trying to keep cold from moving out, you're trying to keep heat from moving in. That's the way energy moves. Okay, got that in there, and then I'm going to put some spray foam. So far on this wall, I have used 2 cans of spray foam. Actually, I'm in my second can of spray foam right now. About 2.5, because I used half the can earlier. So I'm just running this up here. This is really probably not 100% necessary. Really what I'm doing is I'm gluing the pieces in place here, putting this stuff in. Realistically, if I were just going to do this and I didn't have to be concerned about any energy codes or anything, I would just put the 1 inch of foam over this space, and I'd call it a day on that, because that's enough to protect this space from the warmth in the other room. Realistically, there's not going to be that much of a temperature differential because this place is never going to get that cold. It's going to be 50 degrees at the, absolute minimum unless I'm opening windows and stuff like that. So, 1 inch of foam would be fine. But I've got all this stuff. I've got all this scrap foam. It will give me some benefit. I've got to use it up anyway or it's going to go to a landfill. So I might as well get some benefit out of it. And right here, actually, I'm putting a little bit thicker layer because this is right behind the refrigerator. The refrigerator is going to be venting heat out its back up this wall. So this area would tend to pick up more heat than some of the other areas. So to protect this area from the heat, which is really what I'm doing, a little bit of extra foam on there. But I'm just putting them up like this. This is some old packing material. I got lots more packing material. I'm just going to finish this whole wall like this. And then, like I said, cover it all in 1 inch of foam. Have any idea what's back here. Wow, I really messed up the end of this video. But I'm not going to do it again. That's it. Thanks for watching.